Welcome back. This is Moments Nigeria, and tonight is all about looking at those individuals who are making a difference. Now, we are joined by Pascal Achunine. He is a philanthropist involved in various charity programs, including empowerment of widows and feeding of children in slums, and also Kanaya Okonkwo, who is the head for Hospital Visitation Engagement Committee. Very warm welcome to you both. I know you're doing such incredible work. And I'm going to start with you, Pascal. I know you are committing up to 20,000 naira per patient in emergency cases in hospitals. Tell us a little bit about some of the work you're doing.
We are glad to feature on the day you are on the topic, taking the topic, making a difference.
Yes.
Typically, what you see in our society today is lamentation, criticism, and we can go all and on that. Mm-hmm. But we can step out in a little sphere, in a little space, and make a difference. And we figured out that you don't need a billion. You don't need a trillion to start. Mm-hmm. People really need to see that you are credible.
Yeah.
People really need to see you're genuine and sincere. Mm-hmm. And that was the foundation, the philosophy behind the Birth of Health Emergency Initiative. It's an organization that stands in the gap for the poorest segment of the society, mm-hmm. enabling them access basic Medicare. Especially in public hospitals. Mm-hmm. We focus on public hospitals because that's where the indigent, the poor go to. Mm-hmm. And from Mushi General Hospital to Lasuth to Lut to all the public hospitals in Lagos, mention HEI. HEI is a household name. We did not do that by forcing ourselves because typically before you find access into the government space, you must do something unusual. Mm-hmm. But we demonstrated credibility and consistency. That cases that would have led to death. Sometimes you see a case of 2,500 keeping someone in the hospital. You see someone who had given birth in the month of June. By October, the person is still in medical detention. And how much is required? 40,000. 3 weeks ago, in one of the general hospitals in Lagos, both parents were there watching their child, a child of 3 years, and he was unconscious. So when because we verify, we make sure that we don't throw money away because these funds are contributed by widows. We have some in our midst who, in the last 15 months, contribute 2,500 naira to ensure this process is running.
Wow.
It was until recently that a group like Pricewaterhouse Coopers joined us to come. They adopted HEI as one of the organizations they'll be supporting. MRS Oil and Gas also came on board recently. Some groups also went to the web and sought for information about HEI and saw the incredible things that have been taking place in the last 3 years. Mm-hmm. And some have from Canada, from the US, they have shown interest to work with us, especially having put in place strong corporate governance that guarantees transparency and accountability.
Mm-hmm.
But I was citing a case in one of the general hospitals where a child of 3 years was unconscious and the parents were there watching. And when we engaged the social workers, what are the relatives doing? They said they ran around in the last 1 week, they couldn't raise money. How much was needed? 20,000 naira. Our team got there on a Monday. By Thursday, that child was discharged. If that intervention did not happen, we are certain that child would have died.
Mm.
In several other hospitals, several cases that you think that may not happen in Nigeria, actually as low as 3,000, as low as 5,000.
Wow.
So that's what HEI has been doing. But beyond that also, we recognize there is a gap in post-crash situations, post-crash emergencies.
Mm.
We
That's
have
road
a lot
traffic
of
accidents.
Road traffic. We focus on road traffic emergencies.
Yes.
There are a lot of programs and activities towards prevention.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I
inevitably.
I'm so sorry to cut you off, but I know that you're also involved in the hospital visitations. You know, Mr. Pascal has been talking very passionately about just the experiences. You know, so can you tell us a little bit about the None Should Die program?
Yes, the None Should Die initiative was a collaboration with the Federal Road Safety Commission, and it was aimed to ensure that accident victims are attended to even when they don't have money on their pockets. If someone is out and they had an unfortunate situation of a crash, HEI had an MOU with selected hospitals in Lagos State. People are taken there, they are treated on the time, on the spot, no questions are asked, because HEI has already had an MOU. Our primary focus is to save the life of the individual first.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter whether you have money or you don't have money.
Yeah.
You may be rich, but you don't have money at that point. You may be unconscious. And the 18th of December, there was an accident near Costain, involved about 22 patients. 11 of them were taken to FMC, And those 11 were treated on behalf of HEI, and they were discharged and we paid their bills. Some of these victims were not Nigerians. Wow. Some were people who were traveling, who they came to Lagos Island to buy, and on their way home, they had an accident.
Mm. I just wanted to ask very quickly, because we are running out of time. Yeah. Right, like, in terms of education, you provide education and scholarships for gifted children. How do you choose who gets access to those, to
our
those scholarships?
Our focus is healthcare.
Okay.
We need to take a step at a time and be very active and impactful in those areas
first,
before getting to education. But focus is health.
Really quick before we let you go, I wanted to find out, how can anyone contact you if they would like to support HEI?
Okay, we have various platforms we can be reached on. We can be reached via telephone, 234-803-722-8843. The other contacts are the www.hei.org.ng.
Perfect.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.